Welcome. It's almost the new year, right? Just a few days. And what does that mean? It means you need a new calendar, right? Now, if you use Obsidian, you don't have to go out and buy one. It's all just going to happen automatically for the most part, right? Well, I've got a new calendar set up. It's not new. It's not new at all. I just lied to you. It's actually from, as you can see here, from 2021. This gentleman, Antulik, from the Obsidian forums, posted a new calendar setup that he went through and created without any plugins. It's all using inbuilt native functions of Obsidian. So it's very cool. I think it gives it a very, a real life physical planner type feel in a lot of senses. So we're going to go through that. So this was from a few years ago now. And you can see we've got some screenshots and stuff and all that. If we scroll through this and we go to the very next post in that thread, it's him again. Not a single person responded. And 6 months later, he posted his 2022 version because there is some manual setup involved that he takes care of. But even if he stops, it's pretty simple to get it ready for the next year if you need it. 5 months after that second post, we get the first post from someone else. So it didn't really take off very quickly. See, we've even got the 2023 version without many responses. Let's jump through. He just posted a few days ago, about a week and a half ago, the 2025 version. So I'm going to link down below to this forum post so you can grab it and take a look at it. So I've got a test vault here, a bunch of random gobbledygook notes in there. Let's go into the dailies folder and we're going to see we've already got a note set up for every single day of the year. Now, we also have one set up for the month, you can see. So, 2025-01-31, 2025-02, without a day. That one is the month note for February or March. And then up at the very top, we're going to have one that's just 2025. That's going to be kind of a yearly look. And so, what does this do? So the one that's just 2025 is going to transclude the monthly notes, and it's kind of broken down quarter, so first quarter, second quarter, third quarter. And a lot of times when people set these things up, like daily notes or weekly notes that take stuff from the previous week's worth of daily notes, monthly notes that take things from all the weekly notes or however they do it, they use data view, which, you know, is fine. It works. Obviously, it works very good. But this is all native. So this is just the regular transclusion, you know, putting the little exclamation mark in front of a wiki link to include it there. So if we click this little link icon here, let's make this, there we go. If we click the little link icon, we're going to go to that actual note, 2025-1. That's the January month note. And in there, you can see we've got one to-do list already. We can go ahead and we can add more. Let's just add some to-dos for January. Go to gym, some videotapes. So, you know, just something to get our year started off straight. And then we've got, again, transclusions for the week notes that are in January. Right. And so when we click onto that one, now we're in the week two note, which is one of the January weeks. And you can see we still have the month to-do list right up there. And then we've got the days that are included in that week, again, transcluded. So just inbuilt native Obsidian functionality, right? And let's click into one of the days, and we still have the month to-do list right up there on top of every day. And then we've got the week right up there. So this is all manually done. It really only has to be done once, and then getting it set up for the following years is not, I'm not going to say it's not too much work. Not many changes need to be done. I think largely it's going to be like the names of the days, because the 7th won't be a Tuesday in 2026, right? So that needs to be changed. So that already, I think this is pretty cool. And then, of course, you've got the wiki links to all the individual months, all the individual weeks, and all that stuff right up here. So if you want to jump to the Friday in this week that we're at, you just click that, and it's going to go right there. So that's really cool. And then just because of the way that you know, Obsidian works, we can just, oh, you know, I rented some tapes. Let's cross that off. And then that obviously just, you know, marking that off propagates all throughout every instance of the transclusion and the regular note, et cetera, et cetera. So that's very cool. I like that a lot. My only personal concern is I've been, now there's a couple other components to this. We also have the 2025 calendar, which has like a tableized view, which is cool. And we've got two canvas. So we've got 2025 canvas and 2025 mega canvas. So let's jump into these. These are where I think it feels a little bit more like a planner you might buy at a store or something. So this is the 2025 canvas. And as you can not quite see, let's zoom in a little bit. All right. So this is a canvas made out of notes for the month. So if you zoom in enough and you, so it actually shows the notes, you can see we've got that tableized version right over here. And then we have all the month notes right here. So 2025-01, and it's got January and February up here because it's not the full note. Technically, it's just that block, that heading block is what it's showing here. So like when we go into the January note, we can see that we've got stuff above it. We've got stuff below it, but none of that is being shown here because this is just that January to-do list part, which I think is probably a way you can mitigate having super long weekly notes and stuff like that, because you can only have it target specific block sections of the daily notes. So if you do multiple sections, maybe you don't always need certain parts of them to be available all over the place. So you can kind of fine tune the display of the notes by using block level links, basically. So this is really nice. This is gives you a good overview, right? What if you want something a little bit more? What if you just, this is great, but sometimes you just want something a little bit more detailed. That's why we got a mega canvas. It is mega, 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 mega. Look at this. Okay, so we've got, it's kind of a lot going on here, to be honest. Let me, boom. Okay, look at that. So if you had been using the system for a couple years, we would have some previous year stuff on there. So this is 2024 notes right up here. Then we've got spaces, and then we got the next year. So 2025-01-01, Wednesday the 1st, and then on and on. And then on the sides here, we've got the long block right here is the January month note. And then we've got the January weekly notes right here next to it, aligned up with the days of the week that would be in that week. We have some color coding going on, so the actual days are one color and the days of the month are different each month. So we got a blue here, and then we got a green here once it goes into February, then it goes back once it's in March. And then the colors for the month and week ones also alternate so that they're separate from each other going up and down, and from the daily notes adjacent to it, to the right of it. Now, there's another thing here that's done that's pretty cool, pretty clever, I think. We've got a gap here at the end of March, right? And if we scroll down a little more, we got another gap here at the end of June. So that's a visual indicator of the quarters. So if that's something that, you need, if you like to think of your goals in terms of like a Q1, Q2 type thing, or maybe you've got work-related stuff where obviously that's probably terminology and like timing that's used more frequently than in your personal life, that's kind of set up there and ready to go. So this is where you really get like I've got my planner here. I'm opening up the spreads. I got it all, it's very cool. Very, very fun. It looks fun, I think. Right. And then, of course, if you zoom in enough, depending on your settings, I think if you go into the Canvas core plugin settings, you can choose like the zoom level where it does just the names versus actually showing the content of the notes. So if you zoom in, we can see we've got all of those checklists just right there. And again, because this is a block level embedding here, if you do have other stuff that's not under that heading, that's under its own subheading, either beneath it or below it, it's not going to show up here. So that is, I think he just calls it Daily Notes Organized. I think it's very interesting. I saw this last year, 2024. I saw when he posted this there, and it was cool, and I didn't do anything with it. you know, when I saw he had posted the new version of it, I was just like, I want to actually look at this now and let me play around with it. I think it's really cool. And another thing that you can do is you can take one of these files and you can drag it to your sidebar and you can have it, boom, just like that. So you can still have a calendar in your side pane if you want. Can you draw? Can you use a canvas? And yeah, I've never tried that. Yeah, you can. Look at that. Oh boy. Not as easy to navigate. But yeah. That is Daily Notes Organizer 2025 version by Antulik on the Obsidian forums. If you do decide to give it a try, or even if you just think it's cool, go ahead and let them know, because there hasn't been too much discussion on the actual forum post about it. So let him know you like it. Why not? I'm going to do that. It's cool. It's that easy. All right. Happy New Year. Wealth, health, and prosperity to all. Not that I have the ability to grant that, but, you know, it's in my thoughts for everyone. All right. Have a good couple days until the new year begins, and then have even more good days after that or something.